Let me share with you about the evaluation. You know, people worried about assessments and evaluations and how do I measure that they're learning what they should. On that one, there's the Kernel's Compass. And the Kernel's Compass actually tells you in grade one in the schools of America, these are all the topics that they're covering. And in grade two and three and four, so they're going to be doing mountain ranges and they're going to be doing grasshoppers. And guess what? You can find that in the Kernel's volume under this character trait and that character trait. That's what the compass was there for, okay? But it's pertaining to American schools and what's covered there. But regardless of what it's pertaining to, what matters to God? Does it matter to him when they're going to learn about grasshoppers or never, for that matter? It doesn't really matter to him. That's my experience, okay, of God. And what really matters to him is what I'm going to be sharing with you regarding the evaluation here. So you don't need to be evaluating your children on what knowledge they've learned from specific grade levels that they would otherwise be getting if they were in school, because they're not in school. They're at home. You've chosen to bring them home. And you've chosen this Oikos lifestyle, I'm presuming. That's why you're watching this. So this is where your evaluation comes in. Let me read it to you. Last page of the patience unit. Evaluation. Is your child taking more initiative in occupying himself when waiting is inevitable? Next. Does your child think ahead and plan for waiting time? In other words, take along a book or a toy. Next. Has your child been instructed in what to do when you are on the telephone, perhaps? I would prefer it if parents turned their phones off when they're focusing on their children's learning, but anyway. Does your child regularly hear you complain about waiting? So let's just evaluate this. Is your child taking initiative and occupying himself while waiting? In other words, exercising patience constructively. Let me put it to you this way. Our children who are now adults are all full-time in Oikos Family Ministries. When one of them is finished with a project, an Oikos project they've been given to do, they don't sit around, you know, wasting time or going and doing their own thing. What they do is they take initiative and they work constructively towards something while they're waiting to find out what the next project is. Perhaps I'm engaged in some other place and I can't actually show them what to move on with and they have to wait for me. Now, I have to say that I give a lot of this due to Kernel's Living, the fact that they actually have got these characteristics instilled in them now, because we were intentional about training their character, putting God first, what is important to God. So now in the workplace, I'm assured I see before me them exercising patience and doing exactly what they were trained to do when they were little children, just by playing and doing all these activities and discovery learning, because we kept on reminding them of the importance of why God is going to need them to have patience as a characteristic and how to apply that patience, such as what I've read out here on this evaluation. So if you are inclined to start getting caught up in too much of the academic aspect and the knowledge aspect, just go to the end of the unit that you're busy with, the character trait that you've chosen, read the evaluation. That'll keep bringing your focus back to why you're doing Kernos, according to the Oikos learning lifestyle, that is. Some people are taking Kernos and turning it into a big academic education. I can assure you, as you've probably, I'm sure, seen and heard by now, that there's a lot of academics naturally happening. It's just not the focus. It's not the drive. It's not what we're trying to achieve as academic excellence. However, the byproduct is that happens anyway, naturally, without us having to drill it or have an unpleasant learning experience because of it. Okay, so that wraps up the actual how to get through this unit, going through the activities as I've read through them. What I want to do now in the next workshop is bring some illustrations of the actual practical outworking of that in visual form. It's not something I would prefer to be doing because we don't want it to become prescriptive. We're very concerned about people taking somebody else's model and following it to the letter and it not actually working for their family. Each family is a unique family, individual family, that God has got a specific calling on to fulfill a specific function and purpose for him. I know that all, if we generalize, he wants all of us to surrender our lives and to serve him and to teach our children to do the same. But the actual how to go about that is going to be so personalized for each individual family. However, I will go ahead and show you, just to give you a little taste and to start experiencing a little bit of the value, the joy, the pleasure, the examples of this Kernos living lifestyle. I hope this has been helpful to you. And I hope you're excited about jumping into Konos and starting to plan and prepare and get ready with those activities.